So this might come as a bit of a surprise, but I wasn't always the most studious student of mathematics, particularly in graduate school when I was working on my PhD. I took a lot of time in between studies to do things like play Ultimate Frisbee. I was an IT consultant on the side, just as a gig while I was in grad school for a time. I wrote and performed a cappella music about mathematics. But one of the things that I got obsessed with for a brief period later on was anagrams. You know, anagrams where you take the letters in a word and you rearrange them to spell something different. So I did the thing that you usually do when you get into anagrams, and you anagram your name and figure out if it tells you something about yourself. But I also got into anagramming some other things. So for example, if you anagram the words differential equations, if you rearrange the letters, can you spell a description of what it's like to work in differential equations? And it turns out that you can. Inequalities and effort. If you study differential equations, that's pretty much exactly what you come into. But anagrams are interesting not just from a creativity standpoint, but also from a mathematical standpoint, because they're an example of what we call a permutation, a rearrangement of a finite set of objects into a different ordering, right? We use all the same letters, we just put them into a different order. It's an example of a permutation, and we want to be able to study permutations from the standpoint of abstract algebra. So what are our goals going to be over the next few videos? First, we'll provide some motivation for what permutations are. What are some of the various ways in which they arise in mathematics? And we've already kind of seen one, right? The anagrams example. But what we're going to also need to do is figure out how to use notation, two different kinds of notation, what I call stack notation and also cycle notation, to express and work with permutations of a finite set. Second, we're going to have to go a little deeper into what the algebra of permutations actually looks like. So we're going to have to get some practice simplifying products of permutations and also determining the inverses, particularly using cycle notation to do so. Third, we want to understand how any permutation can be written as a product of certain types of permutations called transpositions. And once we know how to write a permutation as a product of transpositions, we can also determine the sign of that permutation. And finally, we want to talk about why permutations are a really big deal in abstract algebra. And in particular, we'll look at a theorem, Cayley's theorem, that tells us why any finite group at all, whether it's cyclic or not, abelian or not, whatever properties it might have, any finite group is the same as a subgroup of a permutation group. And so, in a way, we can discover any kind of abstract algebra regarding finite groups inside of a group of permutations. So these are our goals, and it's going to take us a number of videos to get there. So hang with it, and we'll see where we can go.